Greetings, everyone, and welcome back to Fuzzy Ferret Farm in Stardew Valley. It is a beautiful rainy day. I have a cup of piping hot tea and also a piping hot cinnamon and raisin toasty. Life is generally good as of right now. Alright, got any tappers? Crafty foragers know how to build them. You can attach them to the wild trees that grow all over. Maple trees yield maple syrup, oak trees provide resin, and pine trees provide pine tar. Syrup's the most valuable, but all tree products have their uses. That they do. The spirits are mildly perturbed today. Wow, the spirits are really not particularly happy at the moment. It's going to be clear and sunny tomorrow. Perfect weather for the Stardew Valley Fair. The event will take place in Pelican Town starting between 9 a.m. and 3 p.m. Don't be late, like this episode is. Yes, I'm very, very sorry about that. Ooh, what's happening here?
Hi, Aavak. Phew, that was quite a workout, walking all the way up here. I'm just outside of town. Anyway, I came by to ask if you wanted to have dinner with us tonight. You don't have to, but if you decide to come, could you please bring a largemouth bass with you?
That's right, one of those big slimy fish for the lake. I need one for the casserole I'm making.
Okay, well, it'll be at our house at around 7 p.m. tonight. Don't forget the largemouth bass. Bye. Or rather, don't forget the largemouth bass, I should have said. Do I have a largemouth bass? I do have a largemouth bass.
I'll hold on to that, then. Wow, that has thrown a bit of a spanner into my plans. Aavak, I'm really glad you've become part of our community. I've enclosed a 500 gold check from the Stardew Valley Agricultural Fund to help you continue your good work. Maybe you can buy some more seeds with it.
Thank you very much, Mayor Lewis. Got another letter. Dear Aavak, I just want to remind you that the Stardew Valley Fair is happening tomorrow. Don't forget to bring your 9 items for the grant display, or Grange display. Remember, the fair starts at 9 a.m. in the town square. See you there. Ah, my lord. All of the things, all of the time. No rest for Farmer Aavak. No, no, no.
What's that over there? No, it's nothing. Okay, we didn't manage to get these replanted, and that's something that I'm quite sad about, honestly. Because we may not now have enough time to get anything in there. We'll have to see about that. Grab the mayo. Got any corn? We do have some corn. Fantastic. I'll take all of these. I also need to be sure and carry a pumpkin up to the community center. I'm gonna do it. We already knew this, though, so it's fine. It's fine. I'll pop those in there as well. Actually, I'll also pop that in there, too. Right, okay. So, let's drop off the tar and resin. No, I think we're more or less fine there. I'll take one pumpkin that will be coming with me to the community center, and let's go and check on the girls, shall we? Ba-da-da. I hope you had a pleasant night's sleep, everyone. There we go. There we are. Rumba still only loves me with one heart. Alas. We'll get there, don't worry. Now, let's go and check on the Bat Cave. Have we got much to pick up? Nah. I'm going to leave these. I'm going to leave them on the ground for now. Okay, but as I was saying, I do apologize for the delay in getting this video up. The day yesterday was a bit distracting for a number of reasons that I'm sure you're all aware of. And unfortunately, I had intended to go ahead and record an episode of Stardew Valley a little bit later on and get that up just a little bit later than usual. It occasionally happens. However, the reality was a practice session for the D&D stream that I'll be doing in the future on Wednesdays kind of overrun by a kind of really large number. It was meant to be about three and a half hours long, and ended up being near to 6.5 hours long. So yeah, that was a bit of a pain. It was fun though, but yeah, as a result, quite a lot of things didn't get done that should have been done. Now then, we have got ourselves a slight advancement. We can now very, very rapidly move around the town. So I think we're going to go and we're going to visit Clint.
I mean, I could take my watering can and get that sorted up, but I don't think I should right now. I'm going to have to wait until the end of the season, I think. It's a shame. Or another double day of rain. But let's go straight to the town. There we go. Now we've got that, it's going to be so much easier to get everything done. Hey, Clint. How's it going, mate? Today would be a good day to explore the mines. Who knows? You might find some rare ores down there. I'm glad there's no beef between us. I was a little bit worried. Is that a moonstone? Basalt. It's not a moonstone. Why do I always think they're moonstones? I hope they're moonstones. Lunarite! Moonstone! Haha! I knew it! If I said it enough, it would eventually be in a moonstone. And jamborite. Right, jamborite can go, and lunarite and basalt need to go to Gunther. Thank you very much, Clint. Ah, he's a good sort, really. I feel really bad about Clint. A lot of people said I couldn't, like in their games, they couldn't settle with Emily because it would hurt Clint too much. But my honest opinion is that even if you don't settle with Emily, Clint won't either, because he will never have the confidence to say anything to her. And that's really sad. It's really sad. But honestly, I think Clint is his own worst enemy in that regard. It's self-consciousness that had defeated Clint, not the farmer. Not anything else. Clint defeated Clint. Alas. Alright, let's see what's going on over here. You never know, it might end up like Ace Rimmer. You always think, the people who do best in life are the ones where everything goes right. No. The Arnold Rimmer, yeah, he was the one who got to go to school, who didn't get held back. Ace, though, he was the one who got held back, and what did it teach him? It taught him to fight for things that he wanted, gave him a fighting spirit, and then we all know what happened then. Suddenly, you're parachuting out of planes on the backs of crocodiles. It's grand. It's wonderful. I mean, ultimately, you get shot, but it's still grand and wonderful up to then, and probably a little bit after then. You know, yes, he was wounded, but he still did rescue the princess, amongst other things that he and the princess did together. Ace Rimmer. Never forget. Running low on amethyst. If someone could bring me one, it would be much appreciated. I could try, I suppose. It is early. I could go out and do that. But I want to check something out first, Pierre. Here you go. Fall seeds are here. Crops don't grow in winter, so this is your last shot until spring. Better go all out, huh? Well, it's a little bit late, I gotta be honest. I will sell you the wild plums. I will also sell you two of my duck eggs. Now, these take 13. It'd be right up to the day. We could do that. Or 10 days to mature. No, I wouldn't want cranberry seeds. Amaranth, 7 days, and then you harvest it. If we put the seed grow down, we could get these pumpkins in time. That's the thing that's going through my mind right now. The bok choy, maybe. Yam, maybe. You know what? Sure, let's go for a... No, I'm going to take the risk, damn it. We're going to be brave. There I was, talking about Ace Rimmer, and then I was humming and ahhing over getting yams or pumpkins. No! You know, I could actually see myself becoming a farmer someday. Righto. Hint, hint. I see. Penny, Shane, Maru, We've actually doing really well on the social side of things, even though in my mind, I'm playing the social game a little bit less right now. A little wee bit less. Okay, well, first let's head on up to the community center. Then I'm going to head on over to the farm and plant these pumpkins. And I'm not going to put down speed grow, no. I'm going to go all out. We're just going to hope that I can get it in time. 13 days is all we need. We've got 13 days. 4 crops. Here you go. Oops. What did I get? I got a bee house. How marvelous. Can I get through? No. I must wait. I must learn patience. That I'm not really being patient because I am kind of just sticking right next to him as he was going through. But a little bit more patient than usual. Okay, let's head off, plant these pumpkins. Now, as we've already ascertained, it does count the day that they're planted on. So, as long as I do not miss a single day of watering the pumpkins, then I should get a single harvest out of these pumpkins, which is as well because they only give a single harvest. So, you know, everything seems to make sense and work out in the end. Let's go through there, close the gate behind us, of course. We're not going to leave the gate open. There we are. And down they go. Would have been better if I did these yesterday because we would have no worries at this point. And we could even afford to miss one day's worth of watering. But as things stand, it should be okay. Should be okay. Let's cut this back a little bit. And another beehive. This is actually going quite well. I'm really, really pleased with this. Really pleased. I think we're going to do very well with that. We could head in... 7 p.m. You know what? Maybe I shouldn't go to the mine because I don't know if I'm... will I have enough time to go to Abigail's and to Jody's? That is the question there. That is the question. I'm not sure because I'm fairly certain that when I come out of Jody's, it's going to be like 9 o'clock. Now, the thing is I happen to know that no matter what, the timing doesn't matter. Even if it says, yeah, you come tonight or come tomorrow night or whatever, that quest effectively just hangs around. You can go when you get the next chance. However, I know that a lot of people were hoping for me to go and visit Abigail. So, as I don't know whether or not I will be able to make it to Abigail's place after going to Jody's, I'll go to Abigail's tonight. I'll unfortunately leave Jody and the family meal for now. There we go. Oh, we almost had a perfect. Damn it all. A shad. Actually, let me just double check this. Yeah, just at 7 p.m. That's all I need to do. Enter Jody's house with a largemouth bass at 7 p.m. Which does mean I could, I guess, go and try and get an amethyst. Maybe. I could do that. Though... again, we'd have a little bit of trouble. Damn it. I wasn't looking at that. I was looking at the clock, trying to gauge how much time I really had. I think we're all right. I think we're okay. We'll just fish until later on, then we'll go and see Abigail. There we go. Another shad. There we are. Wow, that one didn't take very long at all. Oh, I'm using my good bait for this as well. Well, maybe I should go down to the ocean and fish instead. And we've got ourselves a salmon. Fantastic. Let's go down here. In fact, I'm going to go and see Elliot. If Elliot's in. Hey, Elliot. Sometimes when I lay in bed, I can hear a distant foghorn cut through the rain. But when I look out the window, I see only a curtain of grey. Ghost ship. That should be written into one of your stories. Maybe it's not an evil ghost ship. Maybe it's just some sort of forlorn sailor. Maybe it's some sort of love thing, where the sailor. Ooh, I'm actually out of my regular bit. Where the sailor and his love were separated, and he just blasting the foghorn, trying to find her, trying to find land. Maybe he crashed trying to get to it. Maybe there was another party. There was a love triangle, and the person who kept the lighthouse was jealous of their love, so he put out the light, and then he crashed the sailor and unrequited love. And then she, kind of like Romeo and Juliet, just cast herself off the cliff in sorrow. And then the lighthouse keeper just hung himself because she had got, oh, it's tragedy. I'm practically writing the book for you here, Elliot. You don't need to thank me. It's all good. Yeah, sure. I've been meaning to do this for a little while. There we go. Perfect. And now I shall just do a little bit more fishing out here. I love the sound of the wind chimes by Willie's shop. Fantastic. Oh, come on. No. Okay. There we go. It's a little bit cold. My fingers are really quite cold. It's remarkably hard to fish right now. Why, really? Why am I fishing in that? No. Twice? There we go. But it is actually really hard to fish right now. I'm finding it really hard to just click my fingers as frequently as I need to. There we go. Come on. Let's get it perfect. Let's prove that I can do it. Oh, nah, scallywags. Really, all the way down? Wow. Okay, not a perfect day, though. Let's try again. Not a maximum cast, either. Ah, I've got to get in fishing practice before we go to the fair tomorrow. There's going to be a fishing stall, and that's pretty much how I get the most of the points that I need. There we go, another sea cucumber and a treasure chest with some bait. Okay, I'll accept that. Oh, drat. I was chatting with Steve earlier, actually, and we were musing as he was saying that he listened to my Stardew Valley episodes to try and help him sleep, and that the sound of fishing and the waves was very soothing, and I was musing with the idea of one day just doing a fishing episode, but without any commentary, just letting it be an ASMR sort of short fishing episode, like 10 minutes of just me fishing, the sound of wind chimes and the lapping of the waves and the occasional cry of a seagull. Very, very soothing. Even while playing, sometimes I forget to talk. There we go. Well, it's 6:40, we're going to have to consider heading out before too long. There we are, red snapper. And let's see what we get. I think it is now considered nighttime. I think it's nighttime from 6 PM onwards, even though it gets darker over the next 2 hours. We've got a fair few fish at this point. We're going to make a decent amount of money, I imagine. We're easily going to make back the money that we spent on the crab pot today. I would not at all be surprised if that were the case. Oh dear, you're a fast one. Okay, I would like you to go down, please. Okay, you don't have to then. I don't really need you to as long as I can get that in time. Ooh. Almost lost you. And let's try and actually get that treasure chest, please. There we go. Oh, an eel. Very nice. Got a lost book. Fantastic. Gunther will be pleased. I don't think there are many lost books left of this. Oh, actually. We're going to head back up. I almost got distracted there. But I don't think there are many lost books left for us to find at this point. Thankfully, this hat has kept my head mostly not wet. But I can't say anything about my pants or my jacket. I mean, I'm imagining, looking at the colors, we're probably talking suede here. Okay. Let's go and see Abigail. Abigail in there? No, Abigail is not. My garden is happy today. Let's head on back out. And then try to come back in. Bomb. Bomb. I will have to see. Oh, it's because Abigail isn't there yet.
But how would that ever happen? You were waiting all day to be able to deliver that punchline. Ah, Abigail, you are wonderful sometimes. There we go. See, all of you people who were thinking, no, this is because you didn't go on the right night. I know what I'm talking about with Stardew Valley, at least some of the time. Hey, I was hoping you'd show up. I want to show you something.
Okay. I like this music.
The moon must be very high and very full at the moment to be casting that much light despite the lights in here. My lord. See this? It's called a spirit board. Have you ever used one? Not personally. At least not one that was called the spirit board. Put your hands on the planchette with me. Okay. Now, the spirits will guide us towards a... Look! It's moving! First letter is I. Next is heart. Even though it's not a letter. Wow, look at it go! Spelling out A. A. I love A. A. Really? You flipped the table. I will never play chess against you. Oops, I accidentally knocked over the board. Yeah, it's just a silly game. It doesn't mean anything. Oh. I have something to do. You'll have to go. Sorry. Oh. Poor Abigail. Right. Yeah, that's about it for today. Let's head on back home then. Didn't get the amethyst, unfortunately. I do feel bad about that. Well, well. It is a dire shame that I did not think ahead enough to get a bottle of melon wine for this. Really should have. There we go. Now, I am going to want to move some things over. Do I already have the diamond in there? Yes, I do. Good. Gold star sea cucumber. I'm really not sure which of these would be the best. Got a cucumber in there already. I've not got a red snapper, though. I'll pop the red snapper in there. Right, go and grab this. And with that, I think we're good to go. I'm going to just drop off what I'm not going to be using in here. We will drop off sardine, don't need that. The anchovy, don't need that. The mayo, that can go as well. The rocks coming with me. Red snap can go in there, soaking the hazelnut. Actually, soaking the sea cucumbers. I will drop off the eel in here, though. There we go. I've got a couple of things that I can take with me. It shouldn't be too hard. Wild plum wine? Not purple. Alas. Alas, alas. Cranberry jelly? Probably also not super amazingly good. I got peach wine. I don't know which one would be best, honestly. Also, there is a tree in my way. You need to go. Also, you need to come with me. Alright, there we are then. I will hopefully be able to do well in the greens display. I'll drop that off. If we can get that, if we can win it, it just means that we'll get a lot of points. Not Starly Finn. Oh, actually, new. Before we do that, I want to pop some melons in there. Also, let's pop these down here. So, wild plum there, and a grape in there. There we go. Now we can go to sleep. At last. How much are we going to make? Made an awful lot there. The cranberry jelly, 200 gold. Very, very nice indeed. And the three mayonnaises brought us quite a large amount of money as well. Okay, yeah, I'm pretty happy with that.
pretty happy indeed. How much did we get in fish? Not amazing. But then we didn't put everything in there that we could have. That was good, though. 3,138. Ye gads. That was enough for two crab pots. And we've got some wild plum jelly as well. I guess I'll pop the peach in there. There we go. Oops, no, I've picked up my rug. Nope, go down. There we go. Right, let's have a look at the television then, rather than picking it up. Fortune teller, the spirits feel neutral today. Well, at least it's not bad luck today, considering. It's going to be cloudy with gusts of wind throughout the day. Very well, let's head on out. Oh, hi, Abigail. Hi, I just wanted to say sorry for acting so weird yesterday. You probably understand what happened. I think I do. Okay. Bye. Alright. I guess that was already awkward enough situation. Thank you very much for coming along and explaining it anyway. Poor Abigail. We do not want this little tree there, so that can go. Now, I've got to get a whole load of watering done. Also, I'm going to have to let the girls out. There we go. There you are, Leafin. Let me go and let the girls out after I collect their eggs. Because if I don't let them out first, then it's so much easier for me to actually say hello and give them a proper pet, etc. Would you really call it petting a chicken? I mean, I would. But it somehow sounds odd despite that. Alright, there you go. You can go out. Now, I super need to make sure that I water all the plants before we go. My lord, got so much... Ooh! Will it? Fairy rose honey. So good. The timing, beyond amazing. Beyond amazing timing. I'm very, very happy with this. Super duper happy. Now, I guess, actually, I don't need to water everything. I could just leave it. But I would very much like a mayo to take with me if I can get one. Let's go ahead and drop off what we've got. That can go in there. Ah, oh, the fairy rose honey. So, such good timing, though. That we are definitely going to be taking with. We'll keep one cranberry jelly. Wild plum one. Actually, no. I think I'll take the peach one with me. So, let's go ahead and start that. Now, let's prepare what we're taking with us. That is for Jody, so that's not coming with. Well, okay, I'll pop her in there in a bit. I will be bringing fairy rose honey, cranberry jelly. I will take the wine. Damn it. And a diamond. Let me just organize this. There we are. Move all of these around. Now, we need 9 items. I've got 4 there, 2 of which are artisan goods. Not so great. I will take a gold star pumpkin, because that should be a very nice crop in terms of its value. Should I take an ancient fruit? Problem there. Problem with that one. I'm not sure I really should. I'll take a gold star rainbow trout or halibut. Or maybe just the eel. No, I'll take a gold star eel. So that gives us 6 items. I need 3 more. Forage, perhaps. I'll take a gold star dandelion. Okay. I think that counts as fishing, though. So I'm not entirely sure on that one. But that's given us 7. I just need 2 more items. Let me sort out my inventory. I guess I could bring along some maple syrup. Sure. And I've got an iron bar that I can bring along, because that goes for mining. Yeah, okay. I think I'll take all... Oh, wait. Need a flower. I need a flower. A gold star sweet pea, I guess, would be okay. Or I could have a sunflower. I've got other sunflowers. Yeah, I've got other flowers, so I'm not going to take the sweet pea. I'll take the sunflowers specifically. Okay, so that's my Grange display set up for now. We'll see if that's enough. Some of you
are really good with the wiki, and you know what everything costs. I know I've had a couple of comments that have been trying to give me advice. I hope you'll understand that for the most part, I tend to... I'm not going to, you know, dress it up as anything other than what it is. I generally ignore things where they're strictly giving me wiki information. I don't really want to know exactly how something is going to play out. It's just not the way I play games. I prefer to have a bit of mystery, and I feel a little bit more accomplished then when I do well, I guess. I know that some people play in a very different way, and more power to you. Play the game the way you want to play. And I do massively appreciate that people want to give me advice. And definitely there are some bits of advice that I have taken from the comments. But when it comes to like things that spoil the puzzle and the challenge of stuff, I try to overlook it where I can. And don't worry, I know that the festival has begun. We are going to be going there in just a moment. I'm just going to get a little bit of this done right now. Get it out of the way, because otherwise, when I come back to take care of all of this later, it's going to be such an annoyance, and it's going to be late at night, and I might not have enough time to do it all. So what I'm thinking is I'll do this top bit first, then I will do everything else, the grapes, that is, later on. And I'm almost out of water. See, I could take the fairy rose. As a flower, that's probably one of the best flowers to take, and I really should have considered that when I was planting them. I should have planted all four rather than just buying one and then running with that. Because if I take that now, all of the honey that I produce from now on will just be regular honey, which wouldn't be quite as good. Let's drop off this. I could bring this with me, and I'm tempted to. Maybe, because these are all artisan goods: forage, fish, vegetable, artisan, mineral, flour. I think I'll take that over the maple syrup, I think. Let me just drop that off. I will then pop this in there. Oh, animal product. Wait. I should bring one of these instead of the multiple artisan. So the cranberry jelly will go in favor of that, or possibly in favor of the mayo. I wonder if this is something different. Find quartz is a resource. I wouldn't necessarily say that was one that I really wanted to take with me. Well, I guess quartz and iron bar. Mineral. Is there anything else? Crafting is the cherry bomb. I could take that, I guess. Monster loot, maybe? I'm not really sure about that, though. I'm not sure about taking monster loot. Tool. No, I think I will take an egg, because that's an animal product, and I will lose the mayo in favor of the cranberry jelly. Okay, that's my lineup. Let's hope that it'll work out for us. Let's drop off the mayo as well. And I think everything else is sorted. I will leave behind the largemouth bass now that I can be, and in fact the corn as well, because otherwise I'm gonna run out of inventory space, I would say. I'll also drop off my food, because I don't think I'm going to need... I'll take one thing of food. And there I am, taking all of my tools as well. That's a bit silly of me. Yes, we should drop off the majority of my tools too. Just don't need them. So, well, I'll take the fishing rod with me. I'll drop off my steel axe. I'll drop off my hoe. I guess the rest is coming with me, just because I don't have anywhere else to put it. Okay, time to go to the fair. Ah, it's going to be grand. I've got an egg with me, but it's fine. Now, that can also be a food product that I will devour should the need arise. But let me just make sure, yes, I've got 9 separate items, and I am happy to use them all. I don't think I need them for anything over here, do I? Do not believe so. No, I would say not. Okay. Hello, everyone. Ah,
Stardew Valley Fair. First things first. Apparently, a lot of people didn't realize this was even a place. Smoked turkey haunch. I guess this festival isn't all bad. Oh, it's nice to see you smiling. I wish Gus would include a vegetarian option. Some zucchini skewers, maybe. Eat as much as you like. It's all free today. Compliments of Mayor Lewis. By the way, perhaps you should include some vegetarian options. Just the word to the wise. I'm trying to get Gus to tell me his sauce recipe, but he won't budge. I don't know. You'd have to have ridiculous charisma in order to get that. I mean, you have ridiculous charisma, but you'd also have to make the charisma checks. I'm thinking nat 20 in order to get Gus to fess up his secret sauce recipe. This barbecue sauce is amazing. Oh, I can only imagine. Tourist. Man, I can't take another bite of this barbecue sandwich. So stuffed. I do like that there are tourists around. Hey, Mayor Lewis. Well, Aavak, it's a big day. Our most important festival of the year, the Stardew Valley Fair. If you'd like to participate by setting up a Grange display, I've left an empty stand just for you. Just let me know after you've set everything up so that we can get to the judging. Very well. Hi, Caroline. Pierre is very serious about his Grange display. He's been setting aside the best-looking produce for weeks in preparation. Much of it probably mine. Scallywag. My soul carries the very finest quality product in the whole valley. Please inspect my Grange display closely and see for yourself. I like you got your custom little thing there as well. Okay, so open up the diamond. Then follow that up with... Well, actually, we'll keep really high value ones over there. We will have wine there and jelly there because they are the same... Well, actually, artisan. These are all artisan in a way. Let me move this around a little bit. We'll have that there. We'll have fish. So animal and fish. Both living creatures. Whereas vegetable and flower are living plants. I guess forage and jam? I kind of lose it there, I suppose. I mean, I could have that there. Actually, you know what? Yeah, let's do that. So that we've got these kind of counterpoint. Oh, wait, no. We'll do this, because then we've got the gold stars. But then we lose this. Oh. Scallywags. We'll put the honey there, because that also comes from, well, living creatures. The insects and then the animals. There we go. I think that works. Sort of, maybe, possibly, perhaps. It doesn't really, but we're going to pretend it does. Hi, Marnie. I tried my best, but my display is pretty weak compared to Pierre's. Not true. Look at the size of that cheese. It is quite possibly the largest cheese I've ever seen. Maybe the judges will give me bonus points for the massive cheese wheel. I think they should. Frankly, if I was the judge, you'd win. Though, actually, I don't know. I like the way you've laid out your display here, Willy. Are you setting up a Grange display, Aavak? Your chance to show off all the good produce from Fuzzy Ferret. I love the fact you know the name of my farm. So good. So good. I approve. Hello. Wow, that's the biggest cheese wheel I've ever seen. Very impressive. See, Marnie? People think your work is super impressive. And the work of your animals, too. Hey, Linus. These animals never judge people by their looks. The same can't be said for humans. It's true, I suppose. What are we going to find down here? Nothing. Can I sneak into the mayor's mansion? Oh, no, yes, no. I can't stand there for some reason. How curious. How very, very curious. What about down here? Is anything going on down here? I can apparently leave by going down there. I wouldn't really want to. It's kind of hectic today. I'm just going to hang out here for a while. Hey, Aavak. Having a good time? Yes, I am. The slingshot tent is pretty fun. If you don't get good at it, you can really rack up the star tokens. Sorry, if you can get good at it. Hey, Shane. All these animals are friendly and love to get massaged. I love the fact that you know this. I love the fact that, because that's the kind of knowledge you'd only get from just randomly deciding, you know what, Pig, you look like your shoulders are tense. I'm going to massage them. Moo! Moo to you too, Vincent. Oh, hen pecked my little finger. Well, maybe you shouldn't be sticking it in his mouth then. And just a few steps over there, Gus is grilling up a batch of pork ribs. Yikes. It's okay. took it. The pigs would eat it. I know that's hard to understand, but they would. The pigs like pork ribs. Pigs like everything. Can I sneak in? No, I can't. My inner rogue is coming out. Nope, can't get in there either. Hey, Clint. I complain about my job sometimes, but I do take pride in my work. These are some of the finest pieces. I hope you like them. That shield looks amazing. I've never even been able to use a shield. Or a mace. Wow. Clint's blades get sharper every year.
So do his prices.
Ah, that's because you keep telling him how good they are. I mean, I think you should continue doing so. He seems the sort of person who needs that kind of, you know, reassurance. But the more he knows, the higher he'll charge. And Warwick, did you set up your tent on Graves? Warwick and I have known each other for a long time. She's a remarkable diviner and a good friend. And that is all I have to say. But that clown, I know him from somewhere. Is it the School of Illusion? Maybe the Carnival of Secrets? Very well. Ah, yes. My crystal ball is swirling with visions of your future, young one. Read my fortune! Ah, I see you in the saloon, surrounded by friends. It doesn't seem like you have any favorites. You're popular with everyone. Okay. Now I see you and Abigail in a dimly lit room. You look serious, but not unhappy. Something important must be happening. The crystal ball has moved on. Ah, you're in combat. There's something dreadful bearing down on you from the dark, but you seem more than ready to face it. Ah, the crystal ball has gone dim. That's all I can do for you, young one. Now, just keep in mind that the future isn't set in stone. Whatever I've told you today can be changed if you set your heart on it. Farewell. How mysterious. Abigail and I in a dimly lit room that looks serious. But not unhappy. Okay. And then I was in combat. And I was also in the saloon, where everybody knew my name. Nope. Can I walk that way? Yes, I imagine I can just leave. And I imagine I was pondering this last time as well. Hey, Robin. Woodworking is an ancient tradition that I'm very, very proud to be a part of. Well, I'm glad. I really admire Robin's carpentry skills. I use a lot of the same techniques in my own line of work. That's really cool. I like the idea that you're close friends and you discuss woodworking tips. Robin really works hard on her carpentry stuff. She deserves a little recognition now and then. Or a lot. Hey, Emily. You know, I would have made a pretty good clown, I think. I missed my calling. You can still be a clown if you really want to. It doesn't look very happy. I guess Mayor Lewis had to cut costs with a budget clown. Budget clown. Oh. Oh, man. Now I'm just thinking of... I forget the name of the character now. The great... from The Watchmen. The thing about the clown. The great... Ah, I can't remember. That's going to annoy me so much now. Oh. The clown who was depressed and went to the doctor. That is going to... that will slowly... dig into my brain and burrow around like an angry worm. I played the strength game too many times and now my arms feel like rubber. Well, maybe you should have just played it once. Have you been to the fortune teller? She set up a stand in the graveyard. I already saw her. She told me something. Interesting. Okay. Better hurry up, kid. Before old Pam finishes every last lunker out of the tent. Fishes, rather. Okay, Pam. I forgot how much of an enthusiastic fisher you were. I won the Wheel of Chance 10 times in a row, and neither man won't let me play anymore. Oh, that was her chance. She was going to make a lot of money and then leave. Now you made you poor, and you could have traded places. I guess that's why you said no. It's a fine-looking town you got here. Nice and cozy, a real sense of community. Oh, I'm glad. Glad you think so. It was a long bus ride here, but totally worth it. This valley's so beautiful. Simon loves it. Don't you, Simon? Sorry, Abigail. I already beat all the games. Now what? Well, therein is the problem with being too good. Now, all of the stalls do you something, and I've been saving this for last. And I'm still thinking of the clown's name. Oh my goodness, that is, it's hurting my brain. But this one's a simple wheel of chance. We'll go ahead, step right up, pick a color, and place your bet for a chance to double your wager. Now, the game is affected by your luck stat. So if you eat food that gives you a luck boost, that's probably wise before coming to this. And also on a day where you happen to be lucky. It's neutral today, so at least it's not unlucky. But generally speaking, I believe you've always got a slightly better chance of rolling green. So we'll try. How many tokens? I don't have any tokens. Alas, no tokens for me. I will come back. I will try and beat the strength game to get a token. So,
are you strong like me? Smash stone!
Okay. And,
oh. Strength level, lumberjack!
I will try again.
Oh. Strength level, ox. Strength level, gorilla!
Come on.
No! Bulldozer!
Okay, that's not too bad.
Ha ha! Ha! Now that's what I like to see. Here, have a star token.
Now, you can do the opposite. And... oh, missed it.
Strength level, shrimp.
Wow, zero strength. I'm actually impressed with how weak you are. Here's a star token. So there we are. We've got two star tokens. The shop over here, I believe, operates on star tokens. I can trade my star tokens for prizes. You need 800 to get the rare crow that everyone in the game loves, probably more than any other rare crow that exists. 2,000 for a star drop, 500 for a fedora, and 100 for dried flowers. The dried flowers, you can get that in other ways. You can just flat out buy star tokens over here, so if you're filthy rich, you can just buy them for a gold apiece. I'll buy one. In fact, I'll buy 8. I'll be 400. Now I've got 10. I can go on this twice. So we'll bet on green, and we'll bet 5. Come on, green. Don't waste my 5 tokens. Oh dear, oh dear. Oh yes, yes. Ha ha! Winner! There we are. I'm up to 15 now. And we are going to all in on this one. There we go. Let's hope luck is still with me. Oh dear, oh dear, oh dear, oh yes! Ha ha! Winner twice! Okay, so there's my 30 star tokens. To be honest, it's probably the fastest way of getting the tokens, but understand that every now and then you're going to lose a lot if you're just doubling your bet every time. However, there are other ways of doing it. You can go over here and you can pay a little bit of money. Play the slingshot game and win star tokens. We will play. This is one of the more fun ones. Remember, you have to draw away. 1, 2. Oops. That was lucky. Come on. Why is it not firing? Oh. I've got to do it in here. I've got to actually hold down the fire button whilst I'm in there. I'm doing terrible this time. Usually I'm a little bit better. There we are. I can just grab it from there. Oh, that was terrible. Absolutely abysmal. My accuracy is so low. You get a multiplier based on your accuracy. So it is better to hit every shot and just hit less shots than it is to go for a load of things and hit nothing. Score 30. Accuracy 69%. 11 of 17 successful shots. No accuracy bonus. No reward. Try harder. Yeah, that was a horrible attempt at the game. I'll try it again just out of, you know, my pride, but... I haven't drawn. Nope. Come on, don't be silly now. Why are you so annoying?
Ow.
Oh, never mind. That was luck, not judgment. Nope. That is not going where the crosshair is going.
Oh.
Close. There we go. And those.
That is not where the crosshair was.
Scallywag. There we are. Those purple ones are worth so many points. It's worth waiting on them and trying to get them because of how much points they're worth. Alas, I probably didn't have an accuracy modifier there. So, probably no bonus. Oh no, 12 stars. That's not terribly, terribly bad. I'm up to 42 stars, but I've spent a lot of money in there. Okay, it's off to the fishing pond with me. Right, play game. Now, this one is just fishing. That's all you gotta do. Oh, I'm terrible at this one as well, apparently. I still blame my frozen fingers. Nope, that's not going to count. Come on. There we go. Time is a ticking. Perfects, I think, count for more. If you can get all perfects in a run, it's going to be amazing. There's no point in going for a higher cast, like a further cast. Cast right next to you if you can. Takes less time to charge up the bar. So you're going to get more casts out in total. Generally, the fish will bite very quickly here, so it really does matter. There we go, another perfect. And there we are. We've got 61 points so far. Not too bad. We've only got about 62 points. We've only got about 40 seconds left, though. Come on. Clocks are ticking. There we are. Now, generally speaking, you will, if you're not too bad at fishing, you can easily make like 200 star points per cast here. Per 50 gold. If you're not as good, you're probably going to be making around 100 points, I would say. Oops. Come on now. There we go. That's a bit better. And unfortunately, those first two miscasts were really quite bad. Let's see how that goes. 99 score. Fish caught 5. 159 perfection bonus. 156 star tokens. So, as you can see, you get a lot more doing this if you're decent with fishing. But let's go and see the Grange display. See how we did. Oh, are you already finished setting up your Grange display? Yes. Okay then, Mayor Lewis, what did we get? Your Grange display has been judged. Return to Mayor Lewis for the results. Very well. You didn't take very long looking at each of those, though, did you? Congratulations, you won first place with a rating of 97. Your prize is 1,000 star tokens. Spend them wisely. Oh, and don't forget to clean out the Grange display box. Okay, I will do this. There we go. Bop, bop. Let's grab all of these. There we go. Hooray, we won! Well, I didn't win, but it was still satisfying to share all my hard work. Well done, Marnie. Wow, I got a low score. I guess Mayor Lewis isn't much of a fishman. Oh, well. Pierre? Can't believe I lost. I shouldn't be as happy as I am, but... Hey, best of luck to you if you enter. I already have entered, and I won! I won against your husband. Nothing to say? Oh, that's a shame. Okay, and we're going to finish off with 1,500 here on green. Let's see what we do. I may not be finishing off with 1,500 on green. I may need to bet a little bit more. And it looks like I won't. Ah, there we go. 5,304. Once you've got about over 1,000, just keep betting. 200s, 500s, 800s, 1,000s, you know, depending on how much you've got. You will win more often than not with green, depending on a little bit on your luck. But there we go. We have got enough now to pretty much buy everything we want over here. So let's go ahead and do that, shall we? I will take the star drop. Oh, nom, nom, nom. Found a star drop. It's strange, but the taste reminds you of tea. Your maximum energy level has increased. Hurrah! We are upgrading ourselves now.
I will also buy a Rickrow. I will also buy the fedora, and I will buy the dried sunflowers. Out of stock! Okay, fedora time. Donk. When I look at face on it, just from the back it looks good. From the front, not quite as good, I will confess. But there we are, walking around with a fedora for the rest of the day, I guess. These were good times. I think it was up to about 1,000 in the fishing spot. But with that all said and done, it is now time for us to leave. We have everything. We've got stupid amounts of stars. Can I give them to anyone else? No, no, I cannot. That is a shame. That would have been fun. I've just passed on my star tokens to someone else who wanted to buy things. Not that there's anything left to buy. I bought it all. Oh, actually, thinking about that. Now, can we go down here? No, we cannot. There is no leaving the fair once you're in the fair. Alas. So instead, I shall head off home then. It has been a wonderful day, and I have made a lot of money, and I didn't humiliate Mayor Lewis or Marnie. I know that has disappointed many, but there's enough sadness in the world right now. I know it would be funny, but what's a joke to one person is something that isn't a joke to other people. There we go. Arcady is trying to sleep very well. Ooh, we've got more honey. How marvellous. So much more honey. Let's grab all of it, shall we? There we go. Now, I do need to go and water my grapes. No. It would help to water my grapes if I had a watering can, as it happens. Kind of a necessary component to watering. However, we're going to make a lot of cash today. There's going to be a lot of money made when we sell all of these. We're not selling the pumpkin. We are selling the cranberry jelly and the peach wine, and we'll even sell that. The rest, though, not selling. Let's drop... I guess we'll drop that off. I'll take these with me. Let's pop inside. We'll just drop a couple of things off in here. Drop those off. We will also pop my hat in there. Ah, things are going well. Very well, if you ask me. Drop that off. No! Scallywag that you are. There we go. Right, finally, we need my watering can. And then I can get to the important job of watering my grapes and also collecting my grapes. Because there's going to be a few for me to collect. Oh, well, there's going to be 6 for me to collect. But all in all, pretty successful festival day in my humblest of humble opinions. Drop that off there. Where shall I put my new Rickrow? That is the question. Where is going to get the Rickrow, I wonder? Am I going to be able to get past you without taking any damage? No. Drat. I thought I was being clever, but alas, no. Ow! Damn it, you almost made me sword my grapes. Well, I mean, I did sword them, but you almost made... Well, yeah, I didn't do any damage. What I meant to say is you almost made me damage my grapes. But thankfully, the sword won't damage crops, it seems. They'll damage trees, but not crops. Okay, well, I'm thinking we should place you... Over here, I think. Sure, you can live here instead. This scarecrow can go elsewhere. Not sure where else, but elsewhere. How about I place you over here or something? How about right there? That'll do. Maybe. That'll do. Okay, well, that is it for me. We need to go and get ourselves some sleep. Rather sharpish. Drop that off for now, and turn in for the night. I'll drop these grapes off in here so that I can make use of them later. There we go. What's that leaf in? Also, new plants that eventually I'm going to need to find somewhere better to put. Oh, long, long day. Long, long episode. I'm going to have to cut out probably a lot of the fair, just the random stuff that I was doing. Try and shrink the episode down a little bit where I can.
and hopefully we won't lose anything of any real substance. Because, for example, in all of the fishing games, I was just fishing and just talking and nattering the way I usually do. Same with the slingshot games. Though I might include more of those because I failed so badly and that was just comical. But where's the fishing? It was just me fishing and I'm generally very good at that. So it's a little bit less entertaining. But I made an awful lot of money, my lord. Peach wine, 420. Cranberry jelly, 200. The 8 fairy rose honeys, 5,440. I can now afford to get myself a backpack and a house. I think this is very good. Very, very good indeed. I am very pleased. Or maybe a house and a fishing rod. I could get that also. Not that far off, a house, a backpack, and an upgraded watering can. Yes, I'm very, very happy with today. I hope you enjoyed the episode, though, and will be joining me for tomorrow. Sorry again that I wasn't able to get this one up yesterday, but as I said, yesterday was a little bit more of a hectic day than usual, a little bit distracting, and I also ended up being roped into 6 hours of practice streaming instead of 3 or 4. So hopefully you can forgive me and are looking forward to the next episode. But as always, remember to like if you liked, sub if you haven't, and until next time, take care of yourselves.